This is the scientific batting practice game as Bob got it. Where, when you originally got this machine, Bob, what kind of condition was it in?
Well, as you can see from the photographs, it was really rough. However, it all seemed to be there, and but it was a tremendous challenge in bringing it back. And you can see from some of the photographs that there was a lot of re-gluing and a lot of adaptations to have it come out like it is today, which to me is, you know, a piece of art.
What about the players?
The players, again, were all beat. As you can see, they were literally destroyed. And again, with a friend from Chicago, he made some new players out of resin. And then I spent, I think, about 10 hours on each player painting him. So what you're seeing is the Cleveland Indians from that period, and the batter is actually home run, or is actually Babe Ruth, number 3 in his pinstripes.
What about the mechanical parts of this and electrical?
The mechanical part was all there, but not operational. But as you're going to be able to see here, it's fully functional and completely original.
Wow. All right, let's look at the way the machine turned out.
Other than get some help to make sure it functions properly, which you can see it obviously does, and the motor is original, so no modifications whatsoever to the functioning system.
That's incredible. What year was this made again?
1941.
41, 80 years old.
Yep.
Wow. So let's start this game up and see what it's like.
Okay, you get 15 balls for a nickel. The first one comes down, and I missed it, as usual. Oh, there we go.
All right.
So I'm going to start it.
Whoa, so the base runners.
Oh, I got a single.
The scoreboard is excellent.
There's another single. Oh, and a double. So now you can see I've scored a run and missed that one. This is not an easy game. I haven't played it a great deal since we just finished.
Well, you got one run on the board, though.
But it's
you got a guy on still, second.
Oh, come on, buddy. There we go. Oh, there's another.
Another one.
Okay, got the guy on the third. Oh,
one more. Come on.
Yeah.
Well, it shows you the last three balls, too.
Okay, got three balls left. One. It shows that on the scoreboard. Two. Let's see if I can get the last one here. Here's some. Okay.
All right.
Well, anyway.
Well, we get the idea of the game.
Get the idea of the game.
That is excellent. That scoreboard is so excellent.
You can see why people enjoy playing it, because it takes
Bob,
a lot of skill.
Tell me about some of the deviations you did to the paint scheme.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, the whole game was painted, and I made some adjustments myself to bring out the wood. Like I did here with my Shoot Hitler and Shoot Toad Dote.
Oh, those two
games.
They
were originally painted in camouflage, but I stripped them all, did them all in natural wood.
Whoa.
While the games inside are all.
Are they in working order, Bob? Are these games?
They are all working
100%
condition.
Working order.
100%
Whoa.
Working condition. Then the other model.
Well, there's not many of these machines around, is there?
Then the other modification I made to the paint scheme with scientific batting practice, originally there was a painted schematic of a baseball player swinging the bat. So since I'd made some of my own deviations, I actually got a photograph of Babe Ruth, an historic one, and attached him to this area. And then if you see here, I got a little baseball that he's looking out as he hits a home run.
Good. He had plenty of those.